normally that would take an hour on its own. So I will try and give you a bit of a consolidated walkthrough. So these are our functions. The simplest thing to do if you want to work out what each of them do is to hover over them. It will tell you this function returns an account balance by the account number. This function returns an account balance by the account name. This function returns the account balance by the account. Come on, Excel. There we go. Returns the account balance by the account type. So as I say, the simplest thing to do is just hover over the formulas and they will tell you what they do. Just to go into them in a bit more detail, you'll see as you go into each of these different categories, there's pretty much three formulas in each of the different categories. I tend to refer to them as the ABAL, NBAL, TBAL function, or the ABUD, NBUD, TBUD function. So as I said earlier, ABAL is going to return an account balance by the account number. Now, let's say, for example, you wanted to build a variance report. So let me pull up that variance report I showed you earlier. Let's say you wanted to build a variance report. In this column here, we've got our actuals. How do we populate our budgets? Well, typically what I say to customers is that for every ABAL function you use, or sorry, for every BAL function you use, there's an equivalent BUD function. So if you were using the ABAL to return a balance for an individual row on a sheet, you would typically use the ABUD function to return the equivalent budget. And you'll see here, if I look in the individual formulas, here you can see we're using the ABAL function. Here you can see we're using the ABUD function. And the simplest way to edit a formula, once you've inserted it into the workbook, is I wouldn't bother trying to edit it by hand. It just gets confusing. What I recommend is you use what we tend to call the little FX button, which is this one here. It's the original insert function button. What it will do is it will take you into the insert function dialog and it will help you through all of the different parameters that you need to follow. Now, in terms of what the different functions and the parameters do, again, the simplest way to figure that out is just to play and just to insert formulas into the workbook. Again, you can reference the sheet, or you can type values in, or you can use the lookup button to grab values from NetSuite. So for example, if we wanted a consolidation balance for all of the four codes, the asterisk is the wild card for Jan 2024. There's a simple formula to do that. That will pull in a balance. That's a single period. If you want a range of periods, you enter the from period and the to period. So let's say I wanted December 2024 as the to period. Again, I can click on OK. Let me change that to 2023 so we get some numbers out. We don't have anything posted to 2024. So here we're looking at all the four codes and the aggregated balance from January through to December. There we go. We've got a number this time. Again, the to period is optional. If you leave the to period out, you just get a single period balance. In terms of the additional parameters, if you scroll down, a lot of people don't see the scroll bar here. If you scroll down, for these original balance functions, you can filter by class, by department, by location. And if you're using OneWorld, you can decide what currency you want to see. So that's based on the parent company. So if I was looking at a USD company and it had a sterling parent, I could use the lookup button to grab the parent company and show the child balances in the currency of the parent. And you can kind of flip-flop between the two. Same for the budgets, exactly the same formulas, except an additional parameter. Subsidiary, budget category. So these are all the different budgets. So let's go back into that demo budget that we uploaded. The account range, I'll do 4-star again. And again, we'll do Jan 2024 because we uploaded to 2024 through to December 2024. And it's the same parameters underneath. So vast department location and so on. And there's our demo budget that we loaded a few minutes ago. Moving on from the original balances and budgets, why have we separated these out? These were the first set of functions we built with Solution 7 for NetSuite. The advanced balance functions have come along more recently, and they give you more control over the data that you want to return. Now, they interact with NetSuite in a slightly different way, so they don't always perform as well as the original balance and budget functions, but you do get additional functionality. Notice these end in APBAL, NPBAL, TPBAL. What does the additional P mean? Well, this is a period balance function, because in against those, we've also got the equivalent functions by date. Now, what does the date give you? It gives you the ability to actually filter at a more, at a deeper level, at a more granular level than period reporting. So for example, if you wanted to do weekly reporting, the by date functions actually allow you to go down to individual dates. So daily postings, weekly postings can all get picked up. And those are actually picked up by the document date, what we would call in the UK the tax point date. So we're not using the financial period now, we're using date. So for example, if you wanted to pick up the week before Christmas this year against the week before Christmas last year to do seasonal analysis, these date functions are great. And again, notice it's the same three functions: ADBAL, NDBAL, TDBAL. I'll show you what the period balance, the APBAL function, looks like. Again, it's the same interface. Again, it's subsidiary. Again, it's a range of accounts, period. And the difference is we've got what we call our option value pairs. So where for the original formulas we had class, department, location, here we've got option one, value one, option two, value two. Think of these as like filters and functions. And you can do things like filter by class, department, location, project, prospect, sales rep, transaction type. So for example, if you wanted to look at bank postings and you wanted to pick up the bank side of a bank posting, you could filter on the transaction type. If you wanted to look at the VAT code on invoices, again, you can apply those sorts of filters to get different balances out. And the other one here is what we call the result basis. And if you're using NetSuite OneWorld, you've got some really neat ways of bending the calculations that we perform for you. So you can do things like switch it from the actual consolidated rate, so the native NetSuite calculation, to things like the average rate, the current rate, the historic rate, or maybe you want to use the budget rate. So you want to compare what do our actuals look like against the actual rate compared to our actuals run against the budget rate. So you can look at FX impact on your numbers. We can choose the account currency. For example, if you want to look at a bank balance, you can look at a bank code and say, I want it in the account currency. So you'll see the bank balance rather than the reporting balance. And you can pull out things like the quantity. Simplest thing to do there is when we send out this recording, I've gone through a lot of information, watch the recording back. But more importantly, just have a play with the different formulas and see which formulas will work for you. Again, I hope that answers your question. And again, that's a 1-hour demo condensed down to about 5 minutes.